think that what the federal government is doing right now in order to honor our ability to be out as who we are is remarkable.
All new at 7, the federal government is telling the transgender community their identity matters.
The Department of Homeland Security is adding an X gender mark for passports. But what does that mean? I'm Krista Fogelsong.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jeff Butera. ABC 7 Devana Lojeski is here right now getting us more on what this change is going to mean for the LGBTQ community right here in Southwest Florida.
Jeff, Krista, the change hopes to make travel more comfortable for all Americans, regardless of their gender identity. The co-founder of Florida's Coalition for Trans Liberation tells me it's a step closer to gender equality.
Leaky Love is trans non-binary and uses they, them pronouns.
For me personally, it means that I don't identify as either a man or a woman. It's a part of who I am. It's my identity. It affects every part of my life.
But for them, it also meant not being able to identify their gender on U.S. passports.
So many trans people struggle and often limit themselves in their travel.
Now the U.S. will offer gender-neutral passports. It will now include an X gender marker, which means unspecified or another gender identity.
It's quite a move for any agency, government agency, organization, family, faith group to recognize us as who we are. So having the U.S. government recognize us as who we are and accept us and embrace us, and also push other countries to do the same, right, in a passport when we have states that aren't even doing it.
But not everyone is on board. Dexter Taylor is transgender. He says he's not a fan. In a statement exclusively to ABC 7, he says in part, "I believe they should remove gender off passports and driver's licenses entirely. They serve no purpose, and a non-binary option will just give more chances for people with the X marker to be discriminated against." Lakey tells me it's hard to celebrate the win after the recent move by the Florida legislature to restrict gender education in public school classrooms.
It's a struggle of being both grateful, but also knowing that it'll be a struggle even after we go ahead and change our gender marker.
TSA will update its pre-check program to include an X gender marker as well. It will also implement gender-neutral screening procedures with a goal of limiting invasive pat-downs. These changes go into effect April 11th. Live in the studio, Amanda Lojeski, ABC 7.